Hey Sims fans, it's really great to be here today. I'm Graham. Thank you for that wonderful intro, Ryan. And like Ryan mentioned, we've got a ton of awesome stuff to show you. We're really going to be focusing on one specific feature in Island Paradise today, just because we are still so early in development. If you tuned into our previous live broadcast, you would have seen our world first announcement of The Sims 3 Island Paradise, and we saw one screenshot at that time. So today you're going to get a much closer look. We're actually going to demo the game, demo it live in game for you. So we're going to jump in there in just a moment. But first, I want to give a little disclaimer. Just because we are so early in development and we've never actually shown an expansion this early before, you are going to see a lot of work that's still in development. We are pre-alpha right now, and the build that we're showing you today is actually about 2 weeks old. I really wish I could show you like what's up on my work PC right now, because the progress we've made over that time has just been incredible. But you're still going to see some amazing stuff today. So, with that said, if you see a little oddity, any strange things in today's build, that's to be expected at this point in development. We've got a long way to go on this expansion, but we're adding a ton of cool stuff. So, with all that said, let's go ahead and jump in game, and we're going to take a look at what you're going to see. Now, here we are, and this is your first look at the world. And like I mentioned, just as I pan around here, you're going to start to get a sense of, what we're going for with the theme, but it's still very early. So a lot of the terrain is still being built out. We're still painting the landscape. A lot of that kind of lush tropical plant life is going to be added later on. So this is still very much in development. But as we come closer here, we're going to get our first look at a port. And a port is going to be a new type of lot that's really your connection between the land and the sea for players who live on the new houseboats. And these are only going to get better over time. You can see I've built out a little dock here, but we're actually going to add stuff like stilted foundations to the game. We wanted to give people the ability to build harbors or even create their own houses or buildings out over the water. So that's really going to be exciting when you see that. It's just not in game yet. And then over here, of course, is my houseboat. Houseboats is one of the huge new features that we're so excited about for Island Paradise. Of course, you've never seen anything like this in a Sims game before. And as I kind of go through here, you can see there's, it's just like a normal home. Even though we're out over the water here, you can still do all the things that you could do in a normal Sim home. Just, in the relaxing setting of a houseboat, which is really cool. So let's have our Sims enjoy a couple drinks here as we get started, because that's how I like to start my island vacations. But you can see, we're on this houseboat. They're kind of living on this hull next to the dock. And even as we go through here, because you're on that hull, you have to be a little smart in how you lay out your home. Because I don't have a ton of room here, so I've got my kitchen all built out. I've got a fully functional living room with a fireplace. Over here, I have a bar for entertaining guests. I've got a little study set up. So it's going to be a fun challenge for players who, like to get in there, like to play with the build tools, and just, make some cool layouts for their homes. So I'm going to send Felix up to the roof here because we're going to get this voyage underway shortly. And I think Katarina, she's enjoying her drink, but before we get this voyage going, I think she's going to want to watch some TV. And just as our Sims move around here, again, you can see how this is a fully functional home. Despite being out over the water, you can still navigate around the household just in all the ways that you normally would and enjoy a full life with your Sims. So let's turn the TV on here. We'll get something exciting on. Oh, of course, I'm doing a demo and the TV's broken, but that's okay. We'll call the repair technician and we'll get somebody out here to fix this up because I've got a special little romantic moment in mind for Valentine's Day later on. So as soon as she gets him on the phone, let's send her out to relax on this nice lounge chair in the meantime and enjoy the view. And it looks like our repair technician will come in about an hour. But I want to get out. I want to hit the open water. So I think he'll catch up to us in a little bit. Now, this is a really exciting moment. You've never seen anything like this in The Sims. I'm going to pull my houseboat away from the dock, And you can see you have full freedom with your houseboats. You can go anywhere, do anything. There's no limits. And like I mentioned, that's my port right now, but I don't have to stay there. There's going to be multiple ports throughout the world on all the different islands, and you can direct your houseboat to go to any of them at any time. And it's really cool to see. And one of the nice things about it is we wanted to bring a real sense of, the world being alive around you. So other Sims are going to be living on their houseboats as well, and you'll actually see them move around and drive their boats to different ports as well. So it's going to be very cool. Now, the houseboats simply aren't all about having the gameplay of a normal Sim home. Again, this gives you all the functionality of a normal household. So even while I'm driving my houseboat around in the ocean, I can switch into build mode or buy mode at any time and fully edit my houseboat. So I'm thinking, a little extra safety on a boat's always a good thing. So I'm gonna grab my life preserver here and pop another one on the wall. And I actually have a problem with this houseboat. I was talking about the layout a little bit earlier, and it's a little tricky, but as I designed this thing, I found I didn't have room for a full bathroom. You can look in there, it's a pretty tight squeeze. Up on the second floor, I've got my bedroom. And then, of course, a place to relax up on the deck. But I really do need that bathroom. So why don't I drop down one of our new objects, the all-in-one bathroom? Now, I love this thing. It is so convenient. I'm just going to plop it down right there in a little nook behind the staircase. And as we peek inside there, you can see you're going to be able to take care of all your hygiene and all your bladder needs for your Sims. And I love this thing so much, I've started placing it in all of my households. It's really cool. It's a fun little toy. And one of the other nice things that we're adding, we're actually bringing ladders into the game. So you're not going to need those staircases taking up all that room. Ladders are going to be a great way to build on houseboats. And I think in behind here, we've got our repairman showing up. He's pulling up on a speedboat. So I'm actually going to switch over to Katarina here and go greet him as he comes to fix my TV. That's the really cool thing. I mean, even when you're out on a houseboat, you're not isolated in any way. You can certainly kind of get away from it all and enjoy your privacy away from civilization. But at the same time, you're not cut off. If you ever want your friends to come over and visit you, if you want to throw a party on your houseboat, or maybe you need some services like getting your TV repaired or having the firefighters show up, they'll just hop on a boat and come out and see you. So it's still really cool and a very convenient way to live. So hopefully she's going to take care of this TV for me, and I'm going to have Felix route us somewhere else. I want to head off in the distance here, go find some islands. Is our TV working yet? I want to show that off later. But one of the cool things, especially when you zoom in here, you start to really get that immersive feeling of being on a boat, being out over the water, as you can kind of see the scenery go by in the windows outside. And it's really neat to see. And looks like we got our TV fixed, but it's such a lovely day outside. I'm gonna turn that off for the moment. And I think we'll go fishing instead. That sounds like a great way to spend my afternoon. So we'll send Katarina down. Yes, thanks for fixing the TV. And let's go fishing outside because this is just a beautiful day. And I want something fresh to throw on the grill later. It's gonna be really nice. So you can see our port in the background over there, where we started the broadcast. We're way off in the distance now, and I'm gonna speed up a little bit because I never know how long it takes for her to catch a fish. But I really want something fresh to throw on that grill later. But it's just really nice. I mean, the convenience of being able to kind of drop what you're doing and just go fishing at any point. You don't have to go search for a fishing hole or find a lake. It's just the convenience of walking out your front door and dropping your fishing line. It's really cool. Ooh, and we caught a nice one. I think that is going to grill up perfectly. So let's send her upstairs to start a barbecue up on the roof. And we'll have her chop that up for us. Come on, Katarina, that's enough fishing. You got a big one. Don't be greedy. But again, you're just kind of seeing how everything that you could do on a normal home, you can certainly do on your houseboat. So she'll come out back here and prepare these ingredients for us. And this is just going to get my taste buds flowing. We are about an hour and a half away from lunchtime ourselves. I might have to grab a little seafood today for myself. So get a little salt and pepper, season that thing just right, some lemon juice. And she's going to carry that upstairs for us. And while she's throwing some food on the grill, I'm going to get this stereo going. Because I got to say, when you're kind of sailing in these beautiful tropics, there's nothing that kind of complements the scene like a little Latin music playing on the stereo. It's the perfect touch for me. Really puts me in the mood. Let's get this grill going here. Oh, that's going to be delicious. Yeah, you might want to keep your face out of the smoke. Come on, Katerina. And here's Felix. We can see how he's actually driving the houseboat around. And you have full ability to go anywhere you want with your houseboat. As soon as he's piloting the ship, I can at any time direct him to, kind of change course or go to a different place. Wherever I want to be, my houseboat can take me, which is just awesome. Oops, still had Katarina there. And I think our fish is just going to be about done. And I definitely want Felix to have a bite. So I'm actually going to drop anchor right here and let them share a nice little meal together. You grab a plate, you grab a plate, and we are going to share a delicious dinner. Now, is this not just the perfect setting? Looking out over this beautiful ocean, enjoying some fresh fish that you just caught, grilling it up, having that Latin music on the stereo. It really sets the scene. It's a nice Valentine's Day moment as well. I wish this is
Meet
something I could
me,
be going home and doing this
Charcuterie.
afternoon, but that's okay. I love being here on the broadcast with you guys. But it's kind of
Meet
one of those
me,
nice things. You get to
Sourdough.
share this private moment. You're away from everybody. It's really a great thing to experience in game. And again, you've never seen anything like this before in a Sims game. So as they kind of finish their meal here, I think we'll get a little dancing going. That'll be a great way to cap off our tasty meal. No dishes. Who wants to wash dishes? We don't do that when we're out enjoying the water. Ooh, poor Katarina. Ooh, I didn't get to her in time. She had a little accident. Instead of dancing, let's send her down to use the all-in-one bathroom. She's feeling a little stinky, so we can get that cleared right up for her. No dancing. Come on, Sims, you gotta listen to me. Oh, he's about to have an accident too. Let's solve this a better way. I'm gonna have Felix use the all-in-one bathroom, and Katarina, she can just take a dip in the ocean to clean up. That's one of the great benefits of being out on the water. You've got it there, you might as well use it. So at any point, I can just jump off the back of my houseboat and go for a swim, which is really nice. Gotta get that stink cloud off you. So, of course, for all of you who are familiar with The Sims 3 Seasons, which was our most recently released expansion pack, we added the ability for all of our players to go out swimming in the ocean and really start to have fun out there. But that's a concept that we're really going to explore further in The Sims 3 Island Paradise, where now we've opened up the ocean, and now we're bringing you all the awesome activities and fun stuff that you can do on it. So I'm swimming out here, but of course, some of the stuff that we're bringing into the game is stuff like snorkeling and scuba diving. And Ryan's going to talk a little bit more about that in detail in a minute, but it's going to be awesome to see. So we'll get her back on the houseboat. I think Felix is probably feeling a little better. Yeah, he got to use that all-in-one bathroom perfectly. And it's getting a little later in the afternoon. Things are starting to cool off, so I think I'll get them into some warmer clothes here. And of course, all the clothes you're seeing today are new and coming with the Island Paradise, so lots of great stuff there. There we go. That's looking a little better. And why don't we have him relax on the bed together? Now that we got that TV fixed earlier, we can definitely enjoy a little special moment together. So here we go. I want to get that TV on, and we'll enjoy a nice little Valentine's Day moment. And what do you know? How convenient is that? We're already tuned into the Romantic Rendezvous channel, which is just perfect for our little paradise here. So I'm going to have my Sims cuddle, really enjoy themselves. Yeah, that's lovely. And then maybe a little makeout session, something special for Valentine's Day. So you can see, when you're out on your houseboat, you know, kind of isolated, cut off from the world, do whatever you want with your Sims, have a fun time, enjoy a special Valentine's Day together. And that's kind of all we're showing for Island Paradise today. We're gonna leave them alone, let them have a little privacy. And you can kind of see what we're doing with the world here. All these cool new islands that you're gonna get to discover, totally unlike anything that you've ever seen in The Sims before. So I hope you've enjoyed what we've shown today. This is going to be how you're going to get to live in your own island paradise, and I'm very excited about it. And that is gonna come out this June worldwide.